How's it going, my gorgeous friends on the internet? I'm so excited. I really want you to have a guess how this effect is done here. All right, so you might be like, oh, okay, we have scroll animation, so maybe like an intersection observer, maybe some GSAP sprinkled in there. No, none of that. This is all vanilla CSS scroll animations. We could do this in 2023, by the way. How crazy! So let me show you how you can implement it, and it's just a couple lines of code. The future is now. Hop on the fucking train. All right, so I just have an Astro project. Let me move myself out of the way here. Just some HTML. Okay, so just open up like a HTML page, add some code in there, and that's it. I added a bit of everything, a H1, a H2, a P, UL, LI, P, pium, 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 all of it. A bit of everything. That's how I like it. Okay, cool. So we have that right here. And I'll just add some minimal styling here so it doesn't look rotten. So we'll just do like a line height here. So I'll grab the body, line height. I'll do 1.5 just to spread the text out a wee bit there, the space in between. There you go. And then we'll do a font family. Let's do a sans serif. There we go. And here's a cool trick. If you want to create dynamic font sizes, you can add a clamp here. And with a clamp, you can, let me just add the values and I'll show you how it works. 125 rem. Okay, so I have the three values here. This would be like the minimum that your font can go. This would be like the maximum size the font can go, and this would be our optimal size. So now when we expand our browser, as you can see, our font slowly gets a tad bit bigger. All right, so the more space it has, the more it's gonna try to adhere and go to this bigger font size. And the smaller you get, as you can see, it tightens up and it just goes to this 1.25. Cool. All right. So that's a nice trick. What else do we want to do? I'll just separate this H1 here from the top just so we have some space for scrolling. So I'll grab the H1 and yeah, I'll just add some font size here and a margin top. And actually, not margin top. We'll just do margin like that to put it in both places. Okay, cool. So we have space to do some animations now. Lovely. Okay, so what should we do it on? Let's do the paragraphs. All right, we want to scroll down and have these nicely fade in. All right, so let's grab the P tag. And well, what did we learn about animations? We learned that we have, what is this on British keyboard? There we go, keyframes. All right, so you create a keyframe, right? You give it any name you want, fade, whatever. And then here you get to define like from and to. So from where do you want to start the animation and what do you want to achieve in the end? So we could do something simple like, well, I want it to start from opacity 0 and I want it to get to opacity 1. And if you want to further customize this, you can change the from to like percentages. So you could do 0%, 50%, and 100% if you want like that. And then maybe you just want your opacity to go from 0 to 1 here till 50, and maybe from 50 you want to do something a bit more a bit different. Maybe you want to do a transform translate or something, right? And then you can have it finish off like that. So you can expand on it and you can add different kind of properties to make this a bit more complex. Okay, but that's all we had. So you attach this on whatever you want. So in this case, our P tag, right? So you create an animation, you add the name, the time, so let's say 3 seconds, an easing function if you want, if you don't want the animation to be linear. And finally, the direction. So you can do forwards, that's just gonna animate once in. You can do both, that's gonna do back and forth as well. Yeah, there's quite a couple. Anyway, that's it, right? Let's remove these two properties for now. Let's just add fade and linear. All right, this is what we'll need for the scroll because when we're scrolling, we want to go from a zero value to one value in a linear fashion, right? We don't want it to have funny easings because it's gonna look quite jaggy on a scroll. So fade and linear, cool. So nothing happens now, but here's the new property that we have. We can use an animation timeline. And we had this before, but we have two new properties on it. We have a view and we have a scroll. And the slight differences between them. We're only going to use view this time, but scroll allows you to attach a scroller to a container. So you can imagine maybe you have like a card on your website, and within that container, you can attach it to that to do the scroll detection. Whereas if you use view here, just like that by default, it's going to attach it to the viewport. So as you can see, as soon as I hit save, look, as soon as the paragraph here at the bottom is going to come into view, you're going to start seeing it fade in. See? So triggered it. And as soon as it reaches the top of the viewport, that's when it finishes. So that's when it reaches one, like that. Now, I only did P here. I also have some LIs. So I can just add a comma here and add the LI like that. There we go. And that's going to apply it to everything now. So as you can see, that's how that works. But what if you want to customize it, right? I don't want the text, like, I'm here. This is still like half grayed out. So you can customize when the elements come in and animate as well. And there's this awesome website, scroll-driven animations, that you can try out. The Google folks set it up. And if you scroll at the bottom here, they have a tool, View Timeline Ranges Visualizer. So besides the besides the animation timeline, we have an animation range that we can define. And you have a couple of different properties that you can use. I highly recommend just experimenting with them. By default, it's set to cover. And look at this. If you go in, as soon as it comes into view, as you can see, it starts animating. But we can modify this. Like, I can modify this so it only starts animating when maybe we're here down the page. All right? So I can move this cover up if I want to. So doop, doop, doop. Let's see, 20%. So now it's going to start animating here. And same with the cover. I can change this to maybe another property like contain, and that's going to go inside. And then I can further move it down. So this is the one I found that works great. And if we scroll down, as you can see, oh, something looks funny, right? So if it looks funny like that to you and it's flickering, let's have a look. This is fine. We need to add here for the animation to go both ways, right? Forward and backwards. And now, as you can see, we don't get that flickering anymore. And as soon as it comes like this far into the view, it's fully, we have the opacity on full. There we go. Cool. Awesome. So how simple is that? We can create complex animations as well. You're not limited to just doing you can do pretty much everything here. Let me show you an example. So let's say we have this H2, right? I'll grab the H2 and check this out. I'll do a background of linear gradient. I'll pass in 90 degrees, black and transparent, like that. All right, so that's what we have. You can see it there. So I can use this to actually hide some of the text and like kind of fade it in from the side, which is really cool. So what I'll do is make this background size a bit bigger just so I can animate more of it. There we go. And then I'll create an animation called reveal. All right, this is going to go again both and linear. Cool. Also, keep in mind, define the animation above the timeline. Animation timeline is part of animation. So make sure this is on top. Otherwise, you might not get it to work. And in Firefox, there's also a bug with the duration. So what you can do is set the animation duration to 1 millisecond. And that's going to fix the Firefox bug as well. Anyway, animation timeline. Let's do another view here. And background repeat. We're going to just disable this as well. No repeat. Animation range. I'm going to use the same that I used here because that was pretty good. So let's pop that in there. Cool. And we need to create these keyframes as well. So let's head down here. Keyframes, reveal. And all I'll do here is from and a 2. And we'll do a background position X. All right. So we'll just shift the linear gradient to the side. So we'll do from 200% to 0%, basically. 0%, save, go. So now if we scroll, as you can see, we have that effect. So what's the point, Ed? That's so dumb. Well, take a look at this. Imagine the white bit of it is transparent, right? And the black bit, think of it like a mask, black, hides, white, shows. What does that mean? Well, we can come here to the top then, and we can add a clip to the text. I can say background, clip, text. and then background. And we have to do the goddamn WebKit background as well. WebKit background clip. There we go. Text. And finally, so it's clipped now to the text. It's behind the text at linear gradient. But what we can do is do a color of transparent, and then the background's gonna show up. So there we go. Now take a look at this. See how that mask works? That is pretty cool, isn't it? Take a look at the browser there. So that's it. I hope you enjoy this. That's really cool. Please experiment with this. I pretty much did the same for the image here with like a background mask as well. But yeah, let me know what you think. Hope you enjoyed this episode. Drop a sub, drop a like, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.